In this video, I'll be showing you how to calculate GPM for a residential wastewater system. GPM stands for gallons per minute and is used to measure water flow, which is the amount of water moving past a given point. For the purposes of this video, the reason for knowing GPM is to determine how much wastewater your sewage system will need to be able to handle. This method uses the National Standard Plumbing Codes, or NSPC's, WSFU tables to calculate flow. WSFU stands for Water Supply Fixture Units, which represents the fixture's demand on the domestic water service to the dwelling unit or building. The newest edition of the NSPC can be found on the PHCC's website. First, we're going to list all of the individual fixtures being used in the dwelling unit, building, or assembly. Next, refer to the NSPC's Water Supply Fixture Unit and Minimum Fixture Branch Pipe Size for Individual Fixtures table. Use the table and record all of the fixture's unit values. Add the values together and round to the nearest whole number to obtain total fixture units. Finally, refer to the NSPC's Table for Converting Demand in WSFU to GPM chart, and simply match the total number of water supply fixture units to the given value in GPM. I'll run you through a basic example. You have a home with a toilet, bathroom sink, bathtub shower combination, a kitchen sink, dishwasher, and a clothes washer. So you would look at the individual dwelling units column and record the corresponding value. The WSFU values for these fixtures added up comes out to 14.5, and rounding up, we get 15. Using the conversion chart, we get 11 GPM, and it's that simple. You now have your flow rate measured in gallons per minute.